the New York Times has purchased The Athletic. Now, The Athletic has been on the block for quite some time. They bought them for $550 million. Now, that is a lot of money. The Athletic has had a ton of subscribers sign up and whatnot. Most people get in when they do their, you know, dollar a month deal, all that kind of stuff. This is a very interesting business decision because typically a sports journalism company would be bought by either a gambling company or somebody else that would have a vested interest in sports. The New York Times is the same journalistic company, the same newspaper company, basically, that awarded the national championship in 2020 in college football to UConn because they decided not to play over the pandemic. This is a weird purchase just on its face. Did you have any thoughts about what is going on with New York Times buying The Athletic?
No, and I find it to be strange because we've talked about this on the show one time. You and I have talked about it multiple times off air. The Athletic's business model was, we're going to work at a loss. They've never made money ever a day in their life. And we're going to work at a loss. We're going to operate at a loss. And we're going to hemorrhage money over and over and over again just to get as many subscribers as we can, just so somebody will buy us. And I've never understood that business model. I've owned several businesses. I run and operate several businesses. That doesn't make sense to me because I don't understand the value of subscribers. But at the same time, obviously somebody at the New York Times thought, well, this is a good deal. We should do this. I don't understand it. I don't know how buying a business that doesn't make any money for an obscene amount of money is worth anything. But, I mean, I guess if you can turn all those people into New York Times subscribers, that would be great. But I don't know that you're doing that because I can't believe the majority of all of the sports, you know, guys out there that are subscribing to The Athletic are the same people that give a damn about the New York Times. Not that that's good or bad. It's just those two things aren't always the same, you know?
Yeah, no, it doesn't. It that's the problem that I have with it is, are they just going to try and roll the Athletic staff into the New York Times staff, and that way they provide more for their New York Times subscribers, and hopefully all the people from the Athletic will then turn over? Or do they just keep the Athletic and try and find a way to monetize it? Because I don't know how you monetize it without ads, right? Oh, I mean, other than charging more per subscription, and when you do that, you're going to lose subscribers. Like, I don't know how much the written word is really worth in today's media market. So
the Athletic is only reason it's got the subscriber base it's got is because it's been so cheap.
Yes.
That's it. That's literally the only reason. If you try to start selling it at what you would, you know, sell, you know, SI or something like that, then I think you're gonna lose a substantial amount of those subscribers. And just a blip, man.
Oh, yeah. I mean,
they're all going to disappear.
Yeah. No, you're 100% right. So a lot of questions about it. I don't know exactly what they will do with it now, but that was big media news for Thursday for sure. Thanks for listening to the Winning Cures Everything podcast. The website is winningcureseverything.com. And if you want to connect with us, we're on Twitter at GaryWCE, at ChrisBGiannini, at Winning Cures, or you can email us, Gary@winningcureseverything.com or Chris@winningcureseverything.com. Subscribe everywhere you need to subscribe, and we'll see you soon.